Alcina's doesn't look much from the outside, but then, neither do we.
Yeah, speak for yourself.
The owner is Betty Joyce Chester Tomeo, or BJ for short. Her name is a mouthful, and so is a soul food.
And we sit here with the queen of soul food in Memphis.
Oh,
there
you are.
You are the world.
Thank you.
You are the Carla. You are the Carla Thomas of soul food, aren't you?
Exactly. Aretha Franklin and the Diana Ross.
Everybody.
The Habitat over in London or whatever. Come on now. Talk about Memphis.
We've come to find out how BJ went from working for a courier company to being a deep-fried diva.
Every day, the menu changes, but every dish is a soul food classic, whether it's catfish or pork chops. It gets served with traditional side dishes and greens. But one thing is on the menu every day, fried chicken, and we're about to be given a masterclass.
We'll take you in the kitchen and show you where the real love making is done.
Oh, here's me thinking.
Thank you, hon. This is here. You know what piece that is?
Leg. Okay. Drumstick. Drumstick.
Right. You know, I had somebody in here didn't know what the wing was.
This is BJ's boudoir of food love, isn't it?
Yes.
And what
a boudoir.
I like to do an egg wash. And that's just now, when I was growing up, my mother didn't do an egg wash.
Really? So how did you get it to stick then, BJ?
That was just that love they had, but they didn't do an egg wash. So we're going to do milk, a little buttermilk. I use a lot of seasoning. Okay, that's a little red pepper. And see, you probably never would have thought to use this in chicken.
No.
And then I put the same seasoning in the flour. This is just something I do, because to me, if you put it in one and don't put it in the other, to me, you're going to end up missing something on the seasoning. That's just my personal opinion. Come on, why y'all standing there? Make yourself useful. Come on here.
Go on, man. Piano.
Right.
Don't both of y'all run at the same time now.
We're having a surfeit of politeness.
We're always quite polite, you see.
Oh, okay, then we just lay that there.
Flame and Nora, this mixture makes your hands sticky.
See, we were always told to hold it for a minute first. For a few seconds. Yeah, because then it doesn't get stuck in the basket. But it obviously doesn't get stuck in the basket anyway.
Yeah, but what do we know? We're English.
The chicken's going to be about 20 minutes in there, so there's time for us to discover the secret of BJ's collard greens, because we're making our own later.
See, this is turnip green. We have cabbage,
right.
That's cabbage green.
Yeah.
These are turnips. Then we have collards, then we have mustard. And then, like, if we do collards, we'll cook the collards, and my mom, like, the last 20, 30 minutes, she put okra on top of them.
Yeah.
And kind of steam the okra from the, from the top. Now, we don't put okra in these, though.
No.
Like, since a lot of people now don't want to eat the pork or whatever, we're using turkey. So she's going to show you how a piece of turkey tail looks.
Smoked
turkey tail, not the white one. Smoked. That's a piece of the smoked turkey tail. Okay, this chicken should be ready about now. So I'm going to show you the coloring of our chicken.
Oh, that's crispy, isn't it?
Filled with love.
Oh, I'm feeling the love.
Now, that's hot now, baby. That's
hot. It's fine. Yeah. That's right, good, isn't it?
But that's... See how it kind of crusts up by putting the buttermilk and the white milk and your different seasoning and whatever. Because, I mean, you can overcook chicken, too. So you don't want to overcook it and you don't want to undercook it. You want it just right.
Yeah. Time to taste the fruits of our labours. Not that we did that much.
Oh, look at that.
Look, that's Isaac Hayes on a plate, isn't it?
This is a taste combination I never thought I'd be eating.
Chicken and waffles.
Chicken and waffles with syrup. This is just... I'm just going to do that, Rob. Oh, what a restaurant this is.
It is, isn't it?
Come on. This is what it is.
Can you taste the love? I'll tell you you can taste the love. Hope you can taste the love.
I've never had fried chicken like that. Mm-mm. So good.
You can't not help feel inspired by cooks like BJ, determined to keep the spirit of soul food alive. And now it's our turn to try our limey hands at making good old fried chicken in our American kitchen. And we're telling you, you're never going to want to get a takeaway again.
And ladies and gentlemen, all good fried chicken starts with, you've guessed it, chicken.
Now, all I'm going to do with a chicken is I'm going to joint it into eight. So we've got two thighs, two drumsticks, two wings, four bits of breast.
Yeah, that's four meats to the bar.
Yeah, good. What? Right now.
And all I'm doing is, I have here a big bowl of buttermilk, and I'm going to add to this a big slug of Worcestershire sauce. The Worcestershire sauce is just our little thing to give it that extra zip in the pip.
And that's what soul is, dude, isn't it? Zip in your pip. It's all flamboyant and...
Yeah.
Oh, love it.
And meanwhile, I will prepare the crispy coating that we're going to immerse the chicken in. I've got plain flour. To this, add 2 teaspoons of salt, 1 of quite coarsely ground black pepper, about 1 tablespoon of paprika. If you like your chicken spicy, use loads of cayenne pepper, and what's optional, some herbs. This is dried oregano. You can put some thyme in as well if you want, about 1 teaspoon of that.
So the chickeny bits go for a bath in the buttermilk and into the fridge for a couple of hours, which gives us time to chill out as well. OK, so this has just been in the fridge for about 2-2.5 hours marinating it, and what happens with the buttermilk is just makes that chicken all soft and lovely and juicy. And then what we do is take a piece of chicken, put it into this perfectly prepared spicy crust, and just toss the chicken in there.
And the seasoning is just adhering perfectly to the buttermilk coating.
Yeah.
We're going to shallow fry our chicken, but it's vital that the oil is at the right temperature. Ideally, it should be around 180 degrees centigrade, much less, and the chicken won't be crispy.
We don't want it too hot, though, or it will simply burn.
So,
nice.
That's what we're after. You want to cook it at about 2 to 3 minutes each side, and then we're going to put it in this tray, stick it in the oven at 180 degrees for about 20 to 30 minutes. This way, you can cook quite a lot of chicken for everybody to eat. So if you've got a big bash, this is what you do. Because don't forget, soul parties weren't small. They were soul parties.
Yeah, if you're going to fry it like this, you're going to have to fry it for about 18 minutes. So you've maybe got 4 or 5 pieces in there. It's not going to work, but this works.
It does.
So do you want to fry on, and should I make the batter mix for the waffles?
Yeah, cool, dude. Yeah, brilliant.
Yeah,
and I'll just crack one.
First thing I need to do is to melt some butter in a pan. Beautiful. I've got plain flour. To this, I had 1.5 teaspoons of baking powder, 3 level tablespoons of corn flour, a good pinch of fine sea salt, and 1 tablespoon of golden caster sugar. Here, I've got some semi-skimmed milk. To that, I'm just going to break in an egg. Just float that butter into the milk. Then we put that into the dry goods to make the batter. And it's a bit like making Yorkshire pudding. The batter needs to stand. But this can stand whilst Kingy's chicken is in the oven.
You see? There's method behind the madness.
Beautiful thing. Oh, look at that. It's dry. It's not dripping with grease. That's cos Si got the temperature perfect. Now, it has been said that we get paid to waffle, but this time we do. Heat your waffle iron to the max and fill with batter. And you see, look, the batter's quite airy now.
It's gone thingy, hasn't it?
It's gone well thingy. And I don't worry if it oozes out the sides. It's part of it, you know what I mean? And shut. And just wait for about 4 minutes, open it up, and out will pop a golden, crispy, rich, sumptuous waffle.
But don't be tempted to open it early, because if you do, you'll tear the waffle.
It'll end up looking like Grandad's string vest.
Aye.
No one there.
No. Look at that, dude.
If you don't have a waffle maker, you could fry up some nice thick pancakes with the same mixture.
Take 3 waffles, 3 pieces of chicken, I reckon, yeah?
Yeah.
And we just douse the waffles in this wonderful maple syrup.
Oh.
Fried chicken, the symbol of soul food.
With waffles and maple syrup.